Alright, try to keep it clean this time, okay? You don't want to revamp on what happened last time, so, yeah. And also, keep your cool sick. There's no point of you of actually going off anywhere else. Let's get started! Alright. We're here. I'm clear. And, boy, do I have some things to work with you. Alright. We got three items on the menu today. Three items, alright? We got the Sobek. We got a laser secondary with the ribbon mod into it. And we got the fire chicken review for it. So you're gonna be in for a little, you're gonna be here for quite a bit of time on it. So, before I go off with the weapons, let's go into the fire chicken, because quite frankly, last night's outburst was really uncalled for. I had to delete the video after I was done. It was really just severely not necessary, even from my point of view of it. But the problem is that I'm so very passionate about my fire chicken here on the PC that I can't help myself. And I mean, literally, I can't help myself. Look at those thighs. Good grief, woman. I got big fat thighs on my own from it, but you just make them look good. Now, let's get away from, let's get away from the guy talk from all this and get into what's going on here. Alright, the changes came in. People are calling it a nerf. People are calling it a good change. And some just don't like it. Personally, these changes are just leaving me in the area where I have to question this. Could it be done better? Could it have been any more different, done differently than this? The answer to this is yes. It can be done different. Should have been done different in the most simplest way of manner for it. But because DE puts a lot of work and effort into it, and also, for some reason or not, it feels like they're stroking your ego with this. But, yeah, I'm not gonna go into it as it is for it, because they went in this direction anyway. So, what's the alternate solution from this? Well, like I said in a previous stream on the video that's now deleted, World on Fire. Why the hell would you actually, how do I put it? Why don't you put it to where it can go to, at least in default, 15 meters and then shrink it down to maybe 5 or 10 meters. That really doesn't do much any good from it, especially from the point of the fact is that it just doesn't make sense to me whatsoever from it. You guys had complaints about from new players and so forth, and I'm willing to bet you someone in there was playing on a new account, heard the word of law from a bunch of players about this and started complaining about it. So instead of fixing it to where if you put overextended, it's not going to extend to another room on it unless the door opens, you decided to scale it downwards. And again, showing off that you know how to do scaling to a point, but not implementing that into another part of the game that pretty much needs this stuff, but I'm not going in that direction for it, but still showing that you know how to scale on all this. And scratching my head going, you could have just lowered the range if it's going to another room and everything else for it, which to me, I would like to sit there and ask how, so I can let my buddy, who's actually a fire chicken fan, he's doesn't know what's going on yet from it, you would like to know how. Because when we were doing this, when we were messing around with his fire chicken, was when the event that happened there in Plains, when we had to defeat the invading infested. For as far as I know of, he was having difficulty keeping that range up and the damage up altogether from it. So, okay. Just shrink it down. Make sure it doesn't go to another part pass of the room. Don't block it off, because quite frankly, the area that you have set for a fire chicken to be out is completely around them. So just shrink that area. That's it. That's all you had to do for it. What the hell is going on here? Next thing. She's lacking in power. I want you to understand something here, okay? You need to understand this. Alright. Players don't usually go on an average from the median section, which is 45. If you're putting everything based on 45 on level, that's fine and all, but that's not really where everyone goes. We go to sorties. We go to endless missions. We go to, well, we go to open world events. Wow, I'm thinking Firefall again. We're going to incursions on Plains of Elendil. We're going to areas where there are high level enemies out there going past 45. And you're stating that the maximum, that it seems like you're pretty much told me during the previews of all this that it can't take out 45. But I'm looking at this going, can it take out everything above it? Because 40 to 45 is not the range that people hang around in. Players don't hang around in that area. They hang around above and below that area. It's never in the center. So now, I'm looking at this going, we got to find a steady middle on this. All right, you put the base of damage, the stock base damage, it could take out 40 to 45 levels. You have it there. Since you've shown and proven that you can downscale on it, why not have the power downscale if it's below 35? Basically, no. Let me say it better this way. Since you know how to scale things altogether from this, why don't you put it to where the standard damage, the base damage, scales up with the level of the enemies? Every other MMO has done that. Whether it's generic or advanced or brand spanking new or revolution, I don't give a damn. They have something like this on there from it. You guys have shown it already. You have proof of evidence here doing it. So what's stopping you? You could do this with abilities. Easy. Sure, it's going to make kind of firepower seem kind of... the scaling itself, it's going to be just base. Okay? Just base. Remember that. All right, we have... How many mods? I think 3-4 mods now that gives us, 5. That can give us 5 mods. No, 5 mods and an Aurora that can give us more power altogether for it. If we stack it up, it's probably going to be a lot more than 200, obviously. But I mean, that's for when we really need to bring in the power for this. This is when we really need to bring in the damage. Just scale the base off the level of enemies. If it's level 1 through 5, well, almost anything can kill it. I don't see what's the problem with that. If it's 20 to 25, once again, almost anything can kill that easily. Hell, if I sneeze at it, it'll probably just probably die off altogether. But when it goes up past 40 to 45, then you scale the damage up to it, to that level. Or you do something that I was thinking of for it. If might as well go by a faction type for it. If, I know this sounds really out of line, but in all honesty, half the decisions I've seen that's been done here kind of throws me off anyway, so might as well throw another wrench into the gear lines to see what happens, whether it eats it up or spits it out. If it's going by, well, where do I start? If it's going by infested, then pure fire and blast. So, fire and blast. If it's going by corpus, you put magnetic and then fire, because quite frankly, why the hell not? And then grenier, corrosive, and then fire on top of it, because quite frankly as it is, you're shooting fire at these son of a guns to the point where it melts, where fire could be at its highest and hottest. It might as well melt armor. It's meant to melt an enemy. That's what fire does. It's to the point where lava could actually melt on it. So what the heck is stopping that from happening? You could do it that way. Or you could just, like I said, scale it up. Damage up to 0. Add a good amount of percentage to that, to the base power. So if it's level 1, you put in level 1 stats, and then you add a little bit of, you add that power up to it. Then you 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, then up to, let's say we're going up to 55-60, you add that extra, you add more bonus power. Not bonus power, you scale up the base power so that it matches the hit points of the enemy for it. We're going to have to eventually use corrosive projectin anyways, and we might as well have to shoot the enemies to strip their armor off. You might as well just have the whole thing set up for that. Or you could just leave the buff as is, with the exception of having to have more drainage to it once it reaches 100%. I love the double damage and everything else for that. Hell, I even applaud it for it. I've seen some enemies go down from that. But the fact that the truth of the matter is that she's never going to reach that point to where maybe a Nova's Monocular Prime would be able to just make them super squishy to it and be more vulnerable to damage from it. Or to where, well, Mag can't do it anymore from it, but before the changes that was implemented to it, the Mag was able to do more damage to these things. Or where Ash can actually kill a few enemies out there that are above combative level 50. Sorry, I'm thinking of the race, but past level 50 and still be able to kill something over it. What's stopping you from holding? What's holding you back on this? Are you afraid that these things are going to end up being sit back and kill off everything for the higher levels? You think we're going to end up sitting there, just standing there, watching our fire chicken collecting dust and all this? There are three abilities if it comes to it, maybe four abilities that we use here. There are going to be players who just stand there, put in world on fire, and then just walk away. But there are players who do more than that for it. Players use world on fire, they use fire blast, accelerant form whenever there's an old crap moment on there from it, but as you can tell, I don't have that much duration on it on the current build. Because I'm going for power, and I'm really pretty much going for power on this whole thing. I want to say something else, too, for this. The changes you did to the fireball. I like it. I really do. It just seems like it's only, like, I don't know how to best put it, but it seems like you only put it for one straight line. You put it up to be a firewall, rather than an actual area from it. So it's kind of really unique for me. I haven't gotten used to it, and I'm still trying to figure this out. I thank you for this. I really wish the charge on the fireball would be a little bit more faster, because the current way how it is, where it's about maybe 3 seconds, 2 to 3 seconds, and during that time, I could pretty much be slaughtered. So yeah, I'm gonna just mass spam one when it comes to it, and trying to take it easy on the gravity. As a fireball tends to, it's designed to arc, but let it arc a little bit more further up. Let it arc a little bit more further so that I can go ahead and literally fire that damn fireball like a grenade launcher would fire its grenade. It just needs that. That's all it needs. Damage, I could care less for it, because the thing is I freaking damage over time. It's wonderful. I say, as I look in there and it says area damage, I may have to put in reach or stretch, whichever one of the two. Is that an ice cream truck? Yeah, it's an ice cream truck. Once when that thing gets louder, I'm going to have to mute it for it. Alright, but getting back to the subject on hand for it. World on Fire just needs a little bit more tweaking. Remove the scale down, put it to set meters with mods on, so that it can be set fully. And I'm not talking about adding corrupted mods and stacking everything else for it. And I mean, it's set at 15 right now. Put it back to 20 meters. 20, 25 meters. Have it reach a cap to how far it can go. If you're in a title set from the Orklin, then have it reach just that one big room in that Orklin. Be able to clear out just that room and not be able to reach past the walls. That's fine. That's a good medium right there to me. And why is my fire chicken turning her back against me? What's going on here? I'm just standing there. She's like halfway around in circle with the way she's standing on this. Good grief. right? But this is what I feel that needs to be adjusted for it, okay? I don't have a problem with what it is right now from this. The energy per second and then the booster damage from it is kind of nice from it. It seems like you were saying, okay, we're going to change this in here, but we don't want you to be pissed off at us fully from this. I was pissed off fully because I didn't like the change altogether from it. This is from first impression that I get from this. It's me spilling out salt because you changed the way how the game is. You changed the way how the fire chicken is on it. I can't help it. I love this bird. I really do. And it's not because of the thighs, like I said before. It's because she's pretty damn good at what she does on it. She's pretty damn well designed. Now, let's move on for that, because I really don't want to spend any more time than I have for it. Here's what I got so far. I set up to range of 21.75. It's going to lower down maybe by 5. Damage is 680, which is fine, because quite frankly, I tend to use Fire Blast for anything that doesn't exactly want to go up in smoke. Fireball. I'm sorry, but I fell in love with the newer Fireball version for this. And once again, I just kind of wish the charge wasn't so slow for it. I wouldn't mind it being much more higher. Holy crap. That is a big... Well. Okay, let's go on here. It does great. We're gonna I'm gonna test it out here with the current build for it. This is gonna be a it's gonna be a generic build. And hit a skip accident. Alright, so I got prime continuity, I got prime flow in there. I'm gonna need the power whether I like it or not. Prime continuity is nice because quite frankly the duration for the fireball exists. And I want that thing there to last as long as possible. Alright. Chancy to Fortitude, Intensify, that's my power generators right there for it. I don't plan of going on Blind Rage because of the fact that matters is that if I do, bye-bye power. Energy Conversion, which of course gives me 50% more ability strength on your next cast. That's going to be there for a different build. That's going to be for the Fireball Spam. But in all seriousness, yes, it's going for a fireball build, and there's going to be one on my hands. Just not going to do it yet. Okay. Already. Fleeting expertise and streamline, because quite frankly, efficiency rocks. Prime continuity fits it in there. I would put it in for constitution, but yesterday's extravaganza was telling me that it only reaches up to 75. And it won't go any more further than that from it. So I'm just going to leave it at 0.85 and just put in a little bit of power to go along with it. Prime flow, obvious reason. Stretch, because I need more range, obviously. I don't want people to, as much as I want them to stay, how do I best put it? I don't want them to just be close to me. I want them to be around me to take them out. All right. This is just pretty much it. Still charged because I need the extra power from it. So, as you can tell, my duration is only around 70%. Hey, when I can't see right in this whole thing. Yeah, 70%. Efficiency, 175. I can't put it any more further than that. Range, 145. And strength at 170. And again, another ice cream truck is coming in. Vitality, because I want to live. Seriously, I want to live. Alright, and this is my generic build. I don't have any other ones in there. If it is, it's kind of outdated. So you can see, like this one here, for example, is duration as hell from that. I don't even know why the hell I have it in the first place. Let me check. What in heaven's name? Yeah, look at that. Yeah, it has no power in it, so... What the hell is this for? I haven't gone to Configuration B since... Let me see, the last time I played the Fire Chicken was... On Configuration B, I think it was when I was somewhat new. When I first... Maybe 2-3 weeks after I got the Fire Chicken Prime. So what you're seeing right now is pretty much default. So it's still continuity, and I got the still charge on that one. So there's the empty one for it. So this is going to be a little more upgraded version from it, right? All right. Let me get a few strong, well, not so strong enemies. You guys said you scaled it up to 45. Good. I'm going to put this one up to 105. I put it at 110, but for some reason I've been told it's not a good idea because that's not the way how this game works with it, and la la la. So let me see. We've got a total of 6, so I'm going to put in 3 on each. Okay, light unit and semi-armored unit. Alright. World of Fire test. I forgot how to mark. That's G. 25 meters. Go 21. And liftoff. Okay, I'm at 100%. So no longer getting hit. Let me check the abilities. Still 21.75, so you're not telling us where it's going to hit. So I'm going to go very slowly to... I see one of them get hit. 14. 13. 12. Yep. It's the only one that got hit. All right. 11. 10 meters. That's some interesting display you got there, buddy. 10 to 9 meters from 21? Aren't you overdoing it there? That's almost 11 meters. So I literally have to be right around semi-end circle here for it. It looks more like as if I'm actually just... yeah, not even full from it. I'm standing close to the dead center, and only this area, these two mobs, let me get that out of the way, these two mobs are the only ones where we're getting hit. So what are you trying to tell me here? You're telling me that it's going to be at a strange angle like this? Like the front end of a triangle? Until I'm nearby. Okay, these guys aren't going down fast enough. I'm going to go ahead and just... there you go. Yeah, you guys are doing something very interesting about this whole thing, isn't it? I was expecting a circle like how, just like how you guys have done with the, yeah, just like how you guys did with the Oberon and his ability. But, well, you kind of proved me wrong on that one. Thanks. Alright. Maxed up. We now know where the area is, and, well, it's 105. It still does some damage to it, which is good. Now, I'm going to move over here. What we got here is going to be the fireball test. We're going to first do the standard ones, which, of course, are going to be spamming. Now. I get the feeling I did some... there's... yeah. So I'm just going to spam this until they're completely dead from it. And I'm going to put some in the middle while I'm at that. So, yeah, just gave me... just like me is just pretty much... just pretty much just painting the ground a little bit in there for it, just so that they can stay nice and warm and cool. You know, a little rotisserie here, a little rotisserie there. You see there's only one already down. And the shields are eating up the whole thing. Alright, that's enough spamming. Let's see what we got. No, they're not dead. They're just dancing. This one's now dead. So what do we got here? We got 2, 3, 4, 5. So nearly a full energy bar full, and only got 5 down. I only have 5 alive, and the 6th one being down. There's the 7th. I'm almost done spamming this whole thing. I'm playing Faco while we're doing this. This is how long I have to wait for the fireball to actually be effective. That one's dead. I'm going to take a look real quick. Yep, that one's dead. I got 4 more. Let me see. You're still alive. You're still alive. So yeah, I got 3 more dancing to the rhythm of the night back here. My Firebird's kind of bored now, and she's tapped. She's out of energy. So about half the enemies are dead. And this one's still cooking a little. And that one's barely alive too. Just the fireball spam from it. I wouldn't mind this actually getting a little bit more better buff, to be honest with you. Because this is the first ability in here. I wouldn't mind it killing something rather than just making it being fricasseed. You ever had flambe? No? You should. It's good. Especially when it's on fire. Now, I'm going to do the next best thing. I'm going to go ahead and use a charge up on this. This is what I mean about it being a little bit too slow for it. And for some reason or not, I can't charge it almost instantly after the thing came out from it. I get the feeling there's a global cooldown, a hidden global cooldown that was put in quite some time back there, because I see ability unused when I'm trying to put the ability to work again. Maybe about half a second's worth instead of full second. Yeah, about a second's worth. Yeah, let's see, there we go. Another like adding a little barbecue to the whole thing from it. Charge up is done. It's doing pretty nice too. Let's get these guys over here. I'm getting that ability use again. Let's add some over here. What I'm grateful for is that the charge up doesn't use much more power while charging up from it. It's really nice. It's really cheap. An efficient way of doing it, and I rather enjoy it this way from it. Let's see what we got so far. I gotta make sure you don't fall back, so it's taking quite a bit of time just to be able to cook these guys out. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to push these guys a little bit far to the side. I'm going to add this. Whoops. Same one flying right out the window. It's alright though. Get that set up for it. Then realize there's no sound. That's alright. Add more sound to it here in a second. so you can hear him roast a little bit. Okay, where are you two? I'm gonna go ahead and leave you two here. Oh yes, nothing like a flame build kiss. Enemy just roasting on the fire while you enjoy your wonderful, glorious day of hard work that you just came from, with all the drama and everything else of the sort, just watching your enemy just roast and burn and go through the same pain you've gone through. I wonder if this thing counts for headshots. Actually almost tapped. It feels like as if I'm being charged double for the fireball spam. I don't know why. That just could be me, though. And I'm tapped. Still alive. Jeez. Yeah, kind of took out a nice good chunk of them from it. Solution? More power. Thing is, I can't. Well, can I? Unless I sacrifice stretch, but you know what? I'm already doing maybe 9-10 meters on World of Fire, thanks to DE. So, no, I don't. I may have to invest in maybe one or two formulas to be able to put this little happy feller, let me find him, here, Power Drift, just to be able to get a little bit more power out of it from it. Do I have anything else in here as empty polarity? Nope, I don't. So, yeah, I'm probably going to need to put two formulas in here, one for here and one for somewhere in here that's got a lot more forward, and looking at prime continuity or flow, and slap on one up here for it. So, yeah. Yeah, would it make things go even more on that, huh? What I'm going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and just put in streamline and test. Just leave it with streamline. Let me see, do I lose or gain on that one? Yeesh. Yeah, that's a lot of energy for it. Okay, but I am just doing that altogether from it. So let me get some firepower back in here. Let's see what's the difference in damage from before and after. That's appearance. Abilities, 740 damage to the fire and everything else to it. Versus, where are you? 740 versus 680. So, letting it increase to 1.75 isn't really going to do that much good for this. About 50% more from it. So let's swap it over. Let's see what happens if I do that and add that in. 214. Good grief. You can't seem to get much into this whole thing from it now, do you? Build a warframe the way you want it to, or suffer the consequences. You're still a little bit constricted on it, so I might as well just do it with this. Simulate the six enemies. Now, I'm just going to do spam on both. I'm going to do just standard spam and charge up spam. So I can just, when I say there's going to be a fireball build for it, you're going to see it here. Because a fireball build, it's going to be just cheap and easy, cheap and easy making. I like how this guy was just free from it. He didn't have any damage on him. His buddies are burning in that, are pretty much burning, but yet he's the only one there just not taking any damage from it. That's kind of an interesting thing. And I'm almost out of power. I'm out of power. So let's see what happens after the Great Bake-Off here is done. So far we have one that's pretty much killed off and barely alive, half-life. Well, he wasn't affected by anything much, and barely alive. I'm barely doing any damage to these poor things. Well, that one was barely alive anyway, so the slam did do some good. No, not really worth that much for it. You might as well just put it for crowd control while you're at it, though. They're mounted, overextended, fleeting expertise. Alright. Not really fully satisfied with the way how it is right now. 10. And I mean this sincerely. 10? Well, I don't know, because 21 to 10, it's going to make me feel like as if I'm doing lines instead of actually trying to kill something here. I'm shaking my head right now. This is supposed to be a proper debuff and buff, but instead it's a legitimate full-blown nerf on it. They want you to lower, they want less range on it, but they're trying to make it up to you by giving you more firepower, more damage onto it. It's just not right. You know that. It's just not right. These frames are meant to be used for area effect. It's not even close to a room for 21 meters on it. Shoot, I have to put in overextended and just to be able to get to where I want it to be from this. And overextended kills off power. No. This is a pretty bad nerf on this thing. This change is just... It doesn't seem like it would be a proper change for it. This doesn't seem like a proper one for me. It's clicking on me right now, stating that, well, if you do put in stretch and overextend, then the firepower the power that you get from that will scale it up to it. The thing is that, well, unless it gives me back the 60% ability strength from it. Let me see, 40, 60. Yeah, it's about 70% right there from it. If I keep this in here, 70%, and then that's 10% ability strength left over from that. You're gonna give me double damage for it. Okay. So why don't we just do this? Okay. I'm gonna take off vitality and put in overextended. Remember, 105 enemies. It didn't kill it off pretty well. It didn't do very well of a job killing it off. So, let's see what happens if we do this. Alright? If it kills it off, I'll stand down and I'll leave it as is and state, good work, and then bow away from the chicken stuff. But if it doesn't, you know you gotta do something. You know you gotta do something about it. Because, quite frankly, it's an ability. It's gotta kill. Actually, let me do this instead. 26. Let me see where my ability is going to be at for it. 35 meters. All right. Got 35 meters to mess with. Power at 440, so it's even less than what I've had on the other build. So 35 meters is right here. Once again, I'm only hitting one or two enemies. No longer taking damage. And the decay is rather quick, too. Once you reach 100. 16. Yep. To 17 meters. It's taking out one of the light units easy. Want to get the feeling that it did something to it. Nope. I'm in the same range now. I'm in 16 meters. That's 18. There we go. My bad on that. I'm at 16 meters straight on from it. Let's wait for that one to take it out. I put fireball on it, but I don't want to mess with the AOE already. Good. I'm going to line myself up with this guy. And then I'm going to go up to it. 17 meters. Beautiful. Okay. Beautiful. So I need overextended to be able to get this thing to where I wanted to at the cost of probably what probably may not be it. Sorry. Actually, I have been thinking about this since it is all over the area from it. It's a surface. It's a circumference. This guy's like barely even getting hit right now. He's getting moved around on his own. So is the other one. There we go. The other one die off? Yep, he did. Because he moved and no longer in the center part. Now they're dancing. The other one isn't, though. We'll hit them soon enough. 85 and 42. Got it. Yeah, he's out of my range. Yeah, he was out of the range. See, he was out of range. All right. Now let's see. I get the feeling someone from DE is watching, so yeah. It's going to get that fixed up again. Let's take off the overextended. Put in. Just take out overextended and just leave vitality in it. Let's see if it does still kill with this on. Woo, 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 woo. Get back over there. I'm not done with you yet. Now you are. I'm just going to stick to 10, since that's where the range is going to shrink to. It shrinks pretty damn quick, though. I thought you guys would have it a slower duration on that one for it. What's it doing? 30? It's doing 90. It's taking its shields on for 400 already. What's this duration? 10? Yeah, it's 10. I'm seeing 400. Jeez. Now you're getting hit by it. 130, 131. 131 at top. Looks like 66 on the bottom end from it. What's your range at, Boyle? 9. What's yours? 10. So you're both... It's an interesting thing on it. They're just... up for it. 131, 195. So you got a choice. You can do overextended and get... What was it? 16 meters? 16, 17 meters away from it? Instead of the 21... Instead of the 2135, or yeah, I think it was 30, maybe 35. I could be wrong on it. I could be extremely wrong about that range that it normally would have for it. Plus, on top of that, the downscaling of the range is a lot more quicker from that. I was under the impression it wouldn't be so very quick. I thought it would be more like where you see my mouse is going doon 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 every second. Instead, it's initial hit, straight down to where you should be, to where it's going to be from it. So kind of, yeah. Jeez. What the hell? So I'm not really sure what to make it think about this thing. I just really don't think it's going to be proper. In all honesty, this is just really not, it's not a satisfying kind of fix or adjustment for it. You're pretty much making me think, you're telling me it's an all-out nerf from this. I understand fully the overextended part for it. I like it, because quite frankly, it's alright. I mean, I understand fully, you don't want it to go over 25 or 30 meters from it, but the way how you're shrinking it down to 16 to 10 meters... 16 with overextended and stretch, and then just with just stretch alone is going to be 10 to 9, 10 meters? Come on! This, I'm sorry, it seems just about right for it, I do understand it, but it's not satisfactory. It's not really satisfactory. If you want it to be just a personal area for it, you might as well not call it World on you might as well not call it World on Fire, because it's not really World on Fire. It's personal space on fire. I mean, this is really, just give me a break, will ya? You can have it set up to at least maximum 25, which is probably just about an average on a room, both in the Orkland and maybe somewhere in the Grenier line from it. But it just doesn't seem satisfactory to it. We have it there so that we can go ahead and take out enemies that are coming in from it, and enemies that still survive the fire blast for it. We have this set up for it. We have fire blast on top of World on Fire, and then now we have this to add on top of it. So they decide to try to go around against us from it. They're toast. No pun intended. But still, they're toast. Let me scale up the damage on this again. Let's see, we're to pile out all the damage from it. This is what we're probably going to need for defense. Or for whenever we're playing, I guess, I want to say escort, but mobile defense in one area for it. The frame is actually ideal for that. He's got a nice little hole line, too. Let's charge this sucker up. Come on. There you go, see? Almost a bullseye target. It might as well be a ring of fire while we're at it. Okay, that's one enough from it. Alright, time for the second half of this. And then I'm going to go over and... Well, I want to put this fire chicken into an infested defense, because infested don't like fire, and I never have. Before I forget, where did we put the buff on the sonic core, on the static core? Thank you. Alright, Sobek. Let's get with Sobek first. Sobek has a total of 3 forma. I'm forced to put in 3, I want to put in 4 so that I can get a full-blown Seeking Fury, but I'm looking at this going, reload's fine. The full version of it is kind of nice for it because it's a 15, but this is going to have to do for it because I need to have some flexibility for it. Shattering Justice, which is from, of course, as you can tell, you get it from Steel Meridian and then Acid Shells. This is your bread and butter. Now, Acid Shells pretty much does an AoE proc of corrosive damage, 45% enemy max health, which is a beautiful thing to me. An absolute beautiful thing on it. The enemies have to die in order for it to proc, though, so keep that in mind. So, you got Vigilant Armaments, which of course is going to give me more status chance for it. As you can see, it's now 98.8%. Back up to where it once used to be for. This is probably close to 70% in the pre-buff state from it. Pinepoint Blank, full maxed rank. Hellfire's Chamber, because why the hell not? This is also your punch through and adds a little bit more to it. So you got your two, elemental, and everything else is going to pile it up to it. So what is it going to be like when it comes to enemies for it? Well, I'm going to waste a lot of time here on this, so you're going to have to forgive me. I'm going to go ahead and keep that maxed up a bit. So, we're going to go ahead and go with the corrosive. That itself already took out a good chunk of the enemy. That was three. Now I only have to spend time on two for it. Doesn't look too bad for 105. But I'm fighting Grineer, so let's take these two out and let's go into Grineer's. Infestation, Grineer. Let's take out a total of five butchers. Now keep it at 105. Whoops. Forgot to hit simulate. Now, I'm going to show you this before I bust out with my Nova, so you can understand why I have my Nova out for it, and why I believe it's a lot more better with the Nova than without. You're literally cleaning the floor pretty well with it. So, why the Nova? Well, because, believe it or not, this has a nice little hidden, what is it, a DE calls it nowadays? Synergy? With the Nova for it, and that's because you take a level 105 Busher and you prime him, and any damage that its neighbor takes on top of the acid shells kind of doubles with the Nova's explosive, and there you go. This is why I said it has a little bit more synergy with the Nova on it. Now, remember that it does lessen the, well, not lessen, it does give out more damage. It forces the enemy to take more damage. But at the same time, what you're doing is you're pretty much stripping the frickin' armor off of it while it's doing this. I'm going to take, I still got six commanders. This is going to be a little bit more troublesome, considering the fact that, well, it's 90, it's 98. Yeah, almost 99%. So, yeah. I'm going to tap the sucker over here for it first. Just wait for the prime to go through. Now, remember, you're not hitting just that person. You're hitting the one next to him for it. So you're hitting multiple targets at once. Whoops, got to reload. There we go. So you're doing a large chunk of damage to these guys from it. And it really just, it hurts for them. It really does. Let's take out a heavy unit. Actually, no, let's put in six. Simulate. Alright. I'm just going to get close enough to prime you. All clear. Now, it's going to take a while because the fact of the matter is that I don't have, the pellets are not really closed off like how it was on the test round from it. So, yeah, you're going to have some interesting time from it, but I'm going to be honest with you. If you have a lot of enemies that have corrosive armor on them, you'd rather have them all getting hit with a shell to be able to have them hurt on it. I'm so used to hitting them in the head, so I'm just going to go with body shots here. And just let full auto take over from it. Now, something else too. Corrosive does land on them, so whatever armor you have in stripped from them, the shells will be able to take over as an extra hit. So they're taking that extra part of damage from it. Let's see. Let's get some infested in here. Let's get some chargers. Let's put up 6 charges. And let's bring it down to... Let's see how they do it. Let's put it on 55, since that's probably where the scaling starts off anyways. Just so you can get a good idea of the demonstration purposes. I thought Valentine's Day was on the 14th. Day after tomorrow. Oh. Oh, crap. Yeah. I'm going to have to take a look at this. Alright. So here we go. Heads down here. Whoops. Whoops. Let's get them alive and let's hit 12. So let's double that a little bit more. That's Grenier. What are you doing? Charger. Uno, dos. 12. Got it? Good. Simulate! What the hell? What the flux capacitor happened here? Can I wave? Okay. That had to be a glitch. No, it is a glitch. What the hell? That was a hell of an interesting glitch. Speaking of glitch, I forgot to... Yeah. Like I said, that was a hell of an interesting thing from it. And I didn't spawn the enemies. What the? I went through it. Should have gotten me... Oh, that's why. Out of bounds. That's fine. Let me swap over to my other configuration. We're going to go ahead and do a funny farm configuration on it. There we go. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to farm him right here, and I'm going to go run for my life for the moment so I can gather them up. Alright. Pretty much all set, right? I'm going to turn off the punch through. Wrong one. Yeah, I meant to turn that off too. And I'm going to put on the original configuration for it. Turn off punch through. I was going to put on it. It's rank 10. Yeah, let's see if I can find it. Because I could put in charge shell, but that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for ammo stuck, more ammo commission, fire rate, status chance. Shell compression, tactical pump. There we go. So it doesn't have any other effect on it, with the exception of what I currently have in it. I'm not going to prime these guys until they're right here facing me. Because, you know, who wants to take a dog for a walk? I do. There's about 12 of them in here. everyone here. Fabulous! Let us prime. There's nothing to link up that poor left one, so, yeah. Alright. The demo for that one's going to come up soon. Let me put in one more here. The Spectra. The only reason why I spent... I was going to say why I didn't spend any mods on this one was rather interesting for it. The only reason why I put this one on for Forma was because of this. Critical chance, zoom, and damage. The zoom, I could probably remove and have replace the decracker, but I'm not going to do so. If you notice, the configuration is almost the same as what I would have in the Golden Guns, mostly because I can't get anything else better for it. So we're going to test this out on a few target dummies first. I'm going to put... Yeah, who wants to blow up an animal? I don't want PETA on me, sorry. We're going to go ahead and test this out on something that isn't in the right level. Pause the AI so I can live. Simulate that. Spectra is pretty much a corpus laser gun. You're meant to be used for mining. I've seen that some actually requested to try to have this as a mining laser to go along with it. Problem is that you really are asking for something to be put in that's already set in with a tier. I believe it's a three tier set. So it's just going to be, it's just not going to be the same for it. So I'm going to go ahead and just, remember, it's got a nice little status set on it for it. But as you can tell, the laser does take some time to get to its point. And I think I forgot to check the status chance on it. There goes one clip. Now you do have the option to be able to, put in a range finder or a range extender for this thing, because it's pretty much, it's a laser gun. Laser beam. So that took about maybe three of them for it. Who am I putting punch through? But this poor thing needs enough damage that can go in. Let me see, 1117, 1039. Damage is between 200 and looks like 500. And that's probably because of the slash damage that's going on with it. Yeah, I wouldn't mind some punch through on this thing, but once again, it needs all the ridiculous amount of damage you can get from it. Hydraulic crosshairs for a little damage booster and 70.4% for that. Putting crit damage altogether from it, so I'm going to see if I can put in... Nope, won't mess with it. It's at 89%. This is how the whole build is, with the exception of this one. So, I'm going to go ahead and do it one more time. See if there's any difference in it. Extreme close-ups. Taking a lot more damage than it would now for it. I think the armor would be stripped off right about now from it, but still, see, it's doing 7 grand in a crit. Now it's doing, did a total of 8 grand from it. This one has a ton of armor on it, so let's see what happens here. And yeah, I did slow. thing I don't see is that it's not procking the corrosive on it, so I really don't think it's good that it is from it. Instead, it's procking the ice. I may have to go back and get the... There it is. Almost out of ammo again. Yep, really almost out of ammo. Only got 9 rounds left. Crack. Yeah, this doesn't seem like it's going to do very well with it. Take out Frostbite. Sure Shot, which is about the same amount. Yeah, this is pretty much it, folks. That gun can't go any more further than this. I'm sorry to say, it's going to have to go into the garbage dump, and this is going to have to go to be on sale with someone else for it. I don't think I rolled it, have I? Yeah, just once, just to see whether I get anything out of it. Alright. That one out. Static core in. Zobic in, so you can see what's going to happen to it. Let's get out of here. I got a fire chicken and a shotgun to show you guys and how well it works before I leave. Jeez. Undeniable. Let's see if it doesn't send me back in here. Because the last time it did send me back to the relay. I don't like it that it did. When I say leave the relay, it leaves the relay, but it brings me back in. And it brought me back to the relay. I could use a navigation system in the relay, but it's kind of buggy. Sometimes it will spawn enemies, sometimes it won't. Other times it will, other times it will just sit there and give you the wrong mission. Alright. Make sure I got everything shut up. I'll put one more in there. Alright. It's time to take the Sobek to a nice little run. Well, I'll take you to my farming grounds. Well, not my farming grounds, my leveling grounds. Since a little bit there for it. It's going to be 22-24. It's only to show you what's the difference between... Just to show you what I mean about the synergy between... Well, between Warframe and the gun itself from it. I've got this on the PS4, but it doesn't have all the format that this one has in it. Mostly because I need to aim for the head. Little swirl. Oh yeah, the color of the acid shells do reflect on the color, do reflect on the power of the they got it. Oh yeah, my Warframe doesn't do this. It doesn't at all. I've got stretch on it and it still doesn't do it. He's primed. Yep. Yeah, there he is. Remember, I don't have the punch through on this one. It's not in. I didn't go back and put punch through on it. So, I'm not doing it as much as efficient as I like it to be. In a way, it does boost out. It does give the range a little bit more of a booster, just so you can see how far off you can get on it. Too bad it doesn't blow that up. Someone just shoot me? Yeah, he's down there. So always monkey spanks who ring the alarm. Hold on, there's one up there. He's the wise guy who sounded the alarm. See? Reload needs to be worked on, but that's what the... There you go. The first AO we didn't kill him, the second AO, let me start again. If the initial fire doesn't kill him, the shells will. If the shells didn't, then... Well, the proc that you get from the mod is going to do the job for me. I see you. There you are. Bonus points if you get him on the head, too. For some reason or not. I kind of wish all the shotguns and weapons do a little bit more bonus damage to heads. Or the crotch, whichever one's preferred. But still, either way, I kind of wish it does. Where is he? He's on the other side. Yep, he's on the other side. We're gonna hold off on priming so you can see how it works without it. Did he just try to kneel? It seems more like he was trying to propose to it. He died before I can kill it. How are you doing? Wait, I missed. Tends to stun him while you're there. This is so much fun. I can't handle it. It's just too much fun. Gonna reload real quick. Golly! They weren't even primed! Oh, yes, they were. No, they weren't even primed. He is. They weren't even primed. I didn't send out the prime that far. Well, these guys respawned. Well, he got killed. What are you doing down there? Sup? See? I love this. I've already cleared out the freaking mission, and I've only just started this in a minute. Gotta love it. Didn't stand a chance. Now, if I did have... I'm just gonna turn this on now. If I did have the other... If I did have the punch through on it, it's gonna go right through an enemy to it. So, if it kills only one enemy and... The acid shells didn't do that much damage to it. It's going to do more damage to it. What the hell? Thankfully, I didn't have to use any more than that. Right, I'm gonna bust out with the fire chicken so that save it for last. We're almost done here anyways. Just get that damn mod in it. Tactical pump, seeking fury, rank 10. It's just much more efficient this way from it. I'm having a blast, no pun intended, but it's becoming much more efficient for me. Enemies are slow, they can run and sound the alarm. If more of them come in during the priming, well, you know, more power to me. Get two more out of it. Come on. All right. Just clears out the room a little bit more, but better. Hold on. Surprised I haven't hit the alarm yet. Or we're going to, anyways. Reload's a little bit more bearable. Let me reset the prime again. Whoops. So many explosions, Michael Bay would be jealous. No, he wouldn't. He would hire the setup just to be able to be in the movie. So meaty. I didn't see him there until now. Go away. Attack! It only does 450 damage. You know, without prime. What the hell do you do that for? I'll just take your buddy out so you can get out. It's only just you, boyo. Have fun going poofy. No, they were. No, they were not. They were not primed. Because for some reason it didn't reach there. I didn't even know he could bleed behind that glass. Holy crap! What the hell? There goes another set. I didn't expect it at all. Oh, man. This guy had no idea what the hell just hit him and everyone else around him. You've been clemmed. That'll be $29.95, please. Hold on. Oh, thank you very much. Now go away. No touchy that control. Wiped out almost everyone, including the freaking field. How you doing? We just cleared the room right there. You can't tell me this isn't good. Come on. I'm not sure if that was people or more of the other stuff. Yeah, that's kind of what it is. That's what it was. I got a stealth kill out of that, too. Yeah, you can shove that machine gun up your butt. Thank you. Okay. You go down anyways. I love my Nova. I loved it when it did this back in the heyday. I'm going to sound the alarm! Okay. Oh, he didn't. Is he over here? Yes, he is. Okay, he was. Where did Bugle Boy go? There you are. He's such a gassy man, you know that? Even if one of them is primed, it still sends off a chain of detonations. Got one more left, gentlemen and ladies. Got one more left. Come on, you have to admit, that was a real blast. Even if it was, no pun intended. What a house cleaner. All right. It's time for the one thing that you guys have been waiting for, and that's, will it roast? So I'm going to do is, let's see, do I have one here? No, I don't. I need a relic. Well, I'm waiting for the keys to actually be made. I'm gonna go put on some weapons. As much as I like hanging around with that one. Take that off. let's see. Can I put on a Gorgon, a shotgun, a wraith, landmine, rocket, boar? We're not dealing with that one in it, so. Let me put on the Quanta. It's been a while. I haven't messed with a Quanta in a long time. Shoot, the last time I touched it was about. When was the last time I touched it? I think before I went on a long break. It took about maybe a year and a half to maybe 2 years. Thank you. Thank you. Got an extra. Nothing, it's just that I recall being on a different planet, but not on Pluto, when Bar came around. That was interesting. I'll just throw in 3 for the fun of it. I'm not sure if you heard that, but I think I heard my collarbone just pop. Might have been on its place or so. I have my maracas. Alright. We're going to go for 10 rounds. See if we can last very long on this one. I don't have much of intent of using the gun unless I have to. But if it does come to it, probably will. Not in full range yet. No, it is. Oh. Wait. What? Oh. It's been a while. Let's see. Last time I checked, it takes all of it but one. Nope, took all of it. Oh, yeah. Fire the laser! Damn! That was a head of a headshot. That was a headshot crit. Well, see the same, my buddies can go running around again. Yeah. Whoops. Now, something else I want to tell you about the energy conversion, or not the energy conversion, the Well, the 15 drain. What it's supposed to do is that it's supposed to give your next ability cast more power from it. Does it work when it's supposed to, when you have this on? I don't know. Because the fact of the matter is that it still needs to be tested out. So right now, I could just go ahead and just... And that one will probably count for that much for it. So I'm not really sure if it's going to go or not. 50% more power is rather nice. Especially more so when you're standing still, if you need to. So you probably could get it up there if you want. Is it Nowara? No. There was one that I have on the PS4 that's a Nowara. And that one is going to be needed to add on top. It's only a 7 energy drain, so you're not going to get very much out of it. Yeah, I'm going to sidestep to the right. Send you on your way. Really did much damage to it. Pew 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 pew. Get me, I really hate it when it does that. Or in turn two. I intend to. Got it before I did. Yeah, let's keep you over there. Let's clean that up. There's still a lot of them there. Uh-oh, here comes trouble. I'm a fine chicken. I would play that song, but I'm not sure if I'm going to get copyright infringed for it. Because, you know, music companies and YouTube are going in for it. The song I was thinking of is, I'm a Love Machine onto it, but it's not going to work. Jeez. Hey, once we start getting close, I'll do it. Usually the thing I don't know is to why in the world there's so very little mobs coming at me. Yeah, this is the effective range right here. This whole entire disc that we're standing on top of is the effective range. All right, someone here. Yeah, this whole plate right here. it's just about as close as accurate as you're going to get when it comes to how much the range is. Let's see if that's me enough to keep you busy. Actually, no. Let's see if this is going to keep you busy. Let's put you here. Let's put you here. Get rid of these. Add some of these and drop another one of these. One over here. Oh, hit that one too. Add one more. Just because I don't want to ignore. You're such a snore. Off you go, you little boar. No, I didn't forget about that one. The final round! Now that you're primed, it's time to go. Gonna make Fireball a lot less expensive. Well, doesn't cost not much money. Not much money. God damn it. The thought of burning money was coming into my hand. No, a lot less to be able to cast would be nice. As you can tell, it's pretty damn effective at what it does. Barely does any damage to it. Let's go grab our loot. Hey guys, guys! Fire chicken is being too—it's being too efficient. Let's nerf it. Okay. You want to know something else too? My sentinel is being too efficient because it's targeting things before it even reaches me. You might want to nerf that too. Get you out of my way. Yeah, you forgot something else too when you said that it got enough energy orbs falling for it, and that's the energy drainers. You forgot to put that in the math. You might want to show us if that's actually in that there or not for it, just so we can have everything cleared up on it. I'm going to do this instead. You see, the energy drainers, the damage absorbers. You forgot to put in infested, didn't you? Ah, you're right. That probably might be reflecting over what's going on there. For let's go from Quanta. Actually, you know, truth, nothing actually gets sustained into it. Nothing can keep sustained when there's about one or two energy drainers out there, so yeah. Wrong button. I don't know why the hell the guy was aiming that high. Gotta reload. Yeah, I don't know how that happened either. Hold on, I gotta reload. And we're out the door. Yeah, they need to extend it a little bit more for it because it's only doing a small ring. Might as well be running around left and right. Trying to get myself killed just to kill something. Alright folks, that's it for now. You've seen the effects of fire chicken, you've seen the range from it. What do you think? Leave your feedback in the Reddit if you're in Reddit or r/Warframe in the Reddit. You don't say anything about me. Because quite frankly, there are people who have better ideas of what's going on from it. I, in the meantime, in for a long overdue time of cooking. My name has been Segar. I'm going to Census. I gotta go find prime parts.
I'll see you.
Next time. Ugh. That was terrible. Excuse me. Didn't mean to burp. Ugh. Tasted funny too.